So I'm going through a proof in the Rothschild and Stiglitz adverse selection model explaining why any pooling equilibrium can always be disrupted by cream skimming. So what do we have here? Well, we've got our axes labeled as usual. We have wealth in the non-accident phase and wealth in the accident phase. We have our point E, which represents our uninsured state. So we make $40,000 in the non-accident state. And on our y-axis here, we have our $40,000 minus the amount of money that an accident cost in this world. So that's point E. The two lines represented here that are dotted represent the actuarially fair line for the healthy and sick individuals. And an actuarially fair line represents every possible insurance package in this world that that makes the insurance company zero profit. So the amount of money they expect to take in from you based on your premium is exactly equal to the amount of money they expect to pay out from you, given your probability of getting into an accident. So the healthy person's line is a lot steeper because we know there's going to be a lot less money taken out of the person's paycheck every month in the non-accident state of the world. The x-axis coordinate here is essentially your wage minus the insurance premium that you pay. And the y-axis is, of course, going to be proportionate to how much they pay out. So this captures every single actuarially fair point for a healthy person. Same thing with a sick person. And here in the middle, we have the pooling line. And in this world, it looks like we have two-thirds of the population, so about two-thirds of the way toward the sick line. Two-thirds of the population is going to be sick in this world based on the way I've drawn the line. About one-third of the population is going to be healthy. So it's pooling both healthy and sick people together. So I'm going to pick a random point on this pooling line, and that's going to represent an insurance package in a state of the world where every single insurance company existing out there is offering this particular pooling package. So this might have a 25% copay required by the individual, and the insurance company covers 75% of costs, since it's about 25% of the way down the line. So what we need to think about this is we need to put our indifference curves onto this map, and actually maybe I'll use a different color. Let me use green for the indifference curves because I know this map gets a little bit messy. There's a lot of things on the curve. So first of all, let's put the healthy person's indifference curves on there. And the healthy person is going to have a fairly steep indifference curve. This will be the healthy person's indifference curve. That's a little bit, basically it needs to be going through the point that we're looking at in a pretty steep way. And so this is going to be the healthy person's indifference curves. Then let's also add the sick person's indifference curves onto the map. So the sick person's indifference curves are relatively flat. And in a different video, I explain the reasons for that. So we have our indifference curves now on this map. And these indifference curves just tell us the way each type of person is preferring this package and which direction is up for them in terms of gaining utility and which direction is down utility mountain in terms of losing utility. So we've got all of the lines on the graph that we need. Now we just need to show that an insurance company can come along and disrupt this equilibrium by offering a cream skimming package. And our cream skimming package is going to be here. Beta, we'll call that beta, just like in the Rothschild and Stiglitz paper, if you open up that paper and read what they do. And we notice that for beta, if an insurer offers this package, it's going to be up utility mountain for the healthy people. So the healthy people are going to be attracted to package beta. The sick people, however, will not be attracted to package beta because it's down utility mountain for them. They prefer alpha over beta because alpha is on a higher part of their utility mountain. This is also a nice point for the insurance company because we notice here's our actuarially fair line that's relevant to beta. Why is it the relevant actuarially fair line? Why is it the healthy person's line? It's because the only people buying package beta are healthy. So whenever we consider profit or loss, we need to make sure we're thinking about the correct relevant actuarially fair line, and that's relevant based on who decides to take up this package. So only healthy people take up the package. This is the actuarially fair line that's relevant. And we're to the left of that line, meaning we're on the profit side of our actuarially fair line. Profit side just means we're taking in more money than we would pay out in an actuarially fair world. It's farther to this direction because this direction makes money for insurance companies. This is raising the price when we go in this direction. So insurance companies are making a profit that's not zero, it's greater than zero, by attracting the healthy and not attracting the sick. And the final thing we need to do here is shade the region where all potential cream skimming packages could be located in this world. So cream skimming packages are not allowed to make a loss because no insurance company is going to make a loss. So they cannot be to the right of that relevant actuarially fair line. They also need to not attract the sick. So we need to have it downhill on the sick person's utility mountain. They also need to attract the healthy. So they need to be uphill on the healthy person's utility mountain. And we can shade the region based on those three criteria. And this is the region that meets all three criteria, makes a non-negative profit, a positive profit for the insurance company. It's not going to attract the sick because it's downhill on utility mountain, and it is going to attract the healthy. So we notice that we cover the region here. We no longer care about this actuarially fair line. That's not going to be a boundary because the pooling actuarially fair line is no longer relevant if you're offering package beta. And since this was a random point on the line, this disproved the existence of a pooling equilibrium. And the interesting intuitive thing about that is this is entirely driven by consumer preferences. So preferences are something that it's really hard to statistically control for. What's going on in a person's heart, you just can't always see, but indifference curves capture that. So because healthy people like paying less and they don't care so much about the accident phase of the world, insurers are able to cream skim them away by offering a package that's attractive to the healthy and not to the sick. And that's it.